Hello friends, welcome back to the second part of analysis of truss. In the first part of truss analysis, we have learned about the trusses and the first method of analysis, that is method of joints. Now in this second part, we are going to learn the second method, that is method of sections. Now in this method, the forces in the members can be determined directly instead of considering the equilibrium of joints one by one. Means suppose if it is asked to find out the forces in few of the selected members, then instead of going joint by joint as it is in the method of joints, we can able to determine the forces in those required members by using this method of section. And the procedure for the analysis using this method of section is as like, first step number one, obtain the support reactions first considering the conditions of equilibrium and apply to truss as a whole. Like in the method of joints, here also in the first step we have to consider the equilibrium of a whole truss, and then by applying the conditions of equilibrium, that is summation of horizontal forces equals to zero, summation of vertical forces equals to zero, and summation of moment equals about any point equals to zero, we are determining the support reactions. Then after determination of support reactions, in the second step, take any imaginary cutting line through the truss which divides the truss into two parts, such that the line, it passes, whatever the cutting line we have taken, that will be passing through the members and it cuts the member maximum three, in which the forces are to be determined. After that, consider any one part of the truss, left or right side of the section, and apply the conditions of equilibrium for the non-concurrent system of force to evaluate the unknown forces. Now let's see we'll solve one of the problem by using this method of section. The example is like, evaluate the forces in the members CE, CF and DF of the truss as shown below. In the question, one of the truss is given A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I and J, where at joint A, a hinge support is provided, and at joint J, a roller support is provided, and at point B, a horizontal load of 20 kN is applied. Now, to solve this, first step one, considering the equilibrium of whole truss and applying the conditions of equilibrium to find the reaction at support. To find out the reaction at support, first of all, you have to draw the free body diagram for the whole truss. Now here you can see in this figure, a free body diagram for the whole truss is shown, where at joint A, this hinge support is replaced by two unknown reactions, vertical VA and horizontal HA. Then at joint J, roller support, so one unknown reaction RJ. Then at B, 20 kN external load applied. Now after completing the free body diagram, apply the conditions of equilibrium. The first, summation of horizontal forces equals to zero. By applying this condition, we get this HA in the negative side, that is minus HA, and then positive minus 20 kN. So we will, after solving this, we get HA as a 20 kN. Then taking the second equation, summation of vertical forces equals to zero. So here there are two vertical forces, VA upward and RJ upward. So in upward direction, it is considered as a positive, that is equals to zero. Then considering the summation of moment about point A equals to zero, taking the clockwise movement as a positive, here VAHA passing through the point A, so moment is zero. Next, 20 kN horizontal force, so perpendicular distance vertical height is given as a 3 meter over here. So 20 into 3, and the nature of moment is clockwise in nature, so positive. Then second force RJ, vertical force, so perpendicular distance is 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3, total 12. And nature of moment is anticlockwise in direction, so minus equals to zero. So solving this, you get reaction at J is 5 kilonewton, and substituting the value in this vertical equation, you get the vertical reaction at A as also 5 kilonewton. Now after this, to find out the forces in the members CE, CF and DF, we have to consider a imaginary cutting line. So here, if I am considering a line which is passing through the members, now this whatever the line we are drawing, that will be passing through these three members CE, then CF and DF. Whenever you are considering this cutting line, the line is taken in such a way that it will passing maximum the three members. Now after that, the truss will be get divided into two parts, like this is the left side section and this one is the right side section. So we have to consider the free body diagram for any one side of the section. It will be either left side or the right side of the section. So here, the next part here, I have considered the left side section of the cutting line. This will be the cutting line. So the force in the members is FCE, force in member is FCF, and here in DE is FTF. And then at A point HAVA, then 20 kilonewton, 3 meter, 3 meter. So this angle of inclination is comes to be 45 degree. Tan inverse of 3/3 is 45 degree. Now again applying the conditions of equilibrium for this, taking summation of H as a 0, so 20 kilonewton in positive X, then plus FCE, then the horizontal component of this FCF, that is FCF cos of 45, then positive FDF, and this will be the minus HA, that is equals to 0. Then taking the summation of vertical forces 0, so one first vertical force VA in upward direction positive, then FCF in a downward direction negative minus FCF sin 45, that is equals to 0. Here then considering the summation of moment about the point C equals to 0, so 20, this 20 is passing through the same line, so the moment because of that is 0. Then HA, whose value is we already determined over here, HA as 20 kilonewton, so 20 HA multiplied by this perpendicular distance 3 meter, and the nature of moment is clockwise in direction, so positive, so 20 into 3, then VA perpendicular distance again 3 meter, and the nature of moment clockwise positive. Then next is the FDF, the perpendicular distance is 3 meter and nature of moment is anticlockwise in direction minus. So substituting the value of HA as a 20 over here and VA as a 5 kilonewton, solving this we get the first FCE as a 10 kilonewton positive, so tension. Substituting in this equation, we get the second force FCF 7.07, and then substituting all the forces in first equation, we get the FTE as a 15 kilonewton. Now this is one more problem solved by using this method of section. Mainly in this problem, how to mark the zero force members, that will be explained. So let's see. Find the forces in the members CE and CD of the truss. So here we have to determine the forces in member CE and the member CD. So now let's start. Initially, whenever we start our solution, mark the zero force members. So now, as we already discussed the conditions for marking the zero force member in our previous video. So let's see. At joint E, here there are three members EG, CE and EF, out of which EG and CF both are collinear. So the forces in the member EF is 0. Then considering the joint F, in this FG and DF are collinear, then EF is 0, so what it represents in CF also the value is 0. Next, at joint C, the member BC and member CE are collinear, CF is 0, so the forces in CD is also equals to be 0. then at D, DF and AD collinear, CD is 0, so the member forces in BD is also 0. So in this way, if we mark the 0 force members over here, the remaining members are here, which carries the forces. So now, the first force we get out of this, that force in CD is equals to 0. Now to find out the force in CF, you can use the method of joint also, or you can use the method of section also. So here I solved it by using method of section. So this cutting line I have taken, which is passing through this member CF, and now after that, considering this right hand side portion and drawing the free body diagram for that, this force is FCE, then here FEF and here FDF. Applying the conditions of equilibrium, summation of horizontal force is 0, summation of vertical force is 0, and summation of moment about the point F as a 0. Solving the simultaneous equation, we get here the force in the member CE as 11.92 kN, in DF as 15.56 kN, then in CF 0 and CD 0. Thank you. So I hope this video will be fruitful for you to understand the method of section for the analysis of trusses. Thank you.